there's clearances that are necessary to have in and around a vented furnace. Underneath a deck is not one of them. And that was...
Here we are, we're down in the basement of one of our clients' houses and we're doing an installation. We're replacing the furnace, air conditioner, the whole system. But what we wanted to show you today is, you know how we've always talked about how the most important day in the life of the new system is, when is that?
The day it's installed.
The day it's installed. One of the reasons we say that is that's when we typically can really make a lot of wholesale changes to improve the design of the system. I'll hand it over to Evan to kind of point things out, but we'll start with the PVC pipe here. This is the exhaust pipe off of the furnace. And why don't you explain, Evan, what we're going to be doing differently here?
Well, what was done when this system here was installed, they vented the exhaust out of the basement through the side of the home, and then that's actually the back side of the home where that big white 3-inch pipe goes through. It's actually underneath a deck, like an outdoor living space, just a wooden deck that's got holes in it and gaps in between the wood, and the furnace is just venting underneath that deck. The way these furnaces work, they burn natural gas, they burn oxygen, and those exhaust gases need to be vented outside the home envelope safely and in a couple different ways so that it's going to work properly. But there's clearances that are necessary to have in and around a vented furnace. Underneath a deck is not one of them. And that was done years ago when this was put in, and by somebody who either didn't know that that's not allowed or didn't quite care. But bottom line, it's one of the things we're going to be fixing today is venting the furnace properly so that it can last as long as possible and work as safely as possible.
And what's interesting, we're going to be taking that pipe out the other side of the house, which was possible to do 10, 15 years ago when this furnace was installed. But guess what? That would have taken a little bit longer, maybe used a little bit more material. It's kind of like this is the closest, easiest place to get the pipe to the outside, but it wasn't the best place to take the pipe to the outside.
Full disclosure, we don't know who.
I have no idea who, I have no idea who did this, but we're going to completely replace all of this. We're going to redo the plenum up here. You can kind of see the patches and things that have gone on over the years. The return air drop over here, as you can see, looks like it's well worn. It was not replaced when this furnace was replaced. So this is a time to clean all that up.
Another thing we noticed when we came down here was another code violation. This is the gas line for the furnace. This is bringing natural gas to the furnace for it to breathe, to burn. And what we're seeing is this is very flexible material. It's not the sturdiest stuff. It's very handy and convenient when you need to make some big angle turns and things like that. But what you can't have it doing is going through the cabinet of the furnace like it is right here. Like I said, this is very flexible, relatively soft material. And you don't want it going through the side of the furnace because vibration, shifting, obviously there's natural gas inside this pipe, and if this pipe ever got damaged or cracked or just damaged in a way that it would leak, that's not a good day for anybody involved. So it's just one of the other code violations that we're kind of seeing that need to be repaired. That should not have been done like that when the system was installed years ago.
The other thing is going to be the type of gas stops that are used. These are the old brass gas stops. We're going to put in a new ball valve that goes through here. Redo all the plenum, things like that. We also have, it's kind of interesting, back when this system was installed, they ran new refrigerant lines. These are these copper lines here. But as you can see, they didn't secure it anywhere. It's literally just hanging in from the joist spaces like that. You see it moving. They left the old original, so we have now two sets of refrigerant lines going through the house. And one end is back here and oil is leaking out of it while it wasn't removed and cleaned up, you know, when it was originally done. But those are just a few things that we do correct when we're out on a job. We pull permits for all the jobs that we do, so it's gonna have a independent set of eyes come in after we're all done and checking it and verifying that yes, we did things properly, it's gonna operate safely, we didn't cut corners, and we have a great reputation with the inspectors of the different municipalities we work in, that they know that our installations, you know, we take the time to do it right. And those are the kinds of things that not all installations are the same. So the most important day of the life of the new furnace is today. So we're going to take really good care of it.